I'm going to get really close and personal with you all today, so just bear with me through this story. So giving you guys some background, I'm going to try not to cry through this part, so bear with me. I'm from the south side of Indianapolis, which is a 5-minute drive from downtown. And so if you guys know anything about the inner city of Indianapolis, you would know that there's a lot of poverty, there's a lot of drug activity, and there's a lot of gangs. There's also, we have a very diverse community, so I grew up with a lot of minorities in my high school. So fast forward to the summer before my 6th grade year, and my parents got divorced. They thought that was what was best for them, but they didn't think about the 4 daughters that they had. So that same summer, my sister Kristen, who is 8 years older than me, left to go to college because we're so far apart in age. So that left my mom and myself and my 2 younger sisters at home in the house that we grew up in. And that left a lot of burden on my mom to fulfill and pay for all those bills. So she got about 3 different jobs, and she was also dealing with depression during that time. So when she wasn't working, she was just shut away in her room, asleep, or just not really conversating with us. So that left me as a 6th grader at age 11 to take care of my 2 youngest sisters. I made sure that they had food to eat, so I made them dinner. I made sure that they got to bed, and I made sure that they did their homework. So fast forward to the sophomore year of high school. My mom had gotten a little better. We had moved houses, so there wasn't as much financial burden. And she tried to come back into my life. But since I had been raising myself for about 5 years and taking care of my little sisters, I didn't feel that I needed her. So at the age of 17, the summer before my junior year of high school, I attempted to get emancipated, and I moved out of my mom and my dad's house. I had stuff at both of their houses, and I decided it would be best if I just moved in with my best friend and her family. That same summer, my sister graduated with an associate's degree, and she was now married and had a house about 5 minutes away from me in the same area of town. But because I was living with my best friend, I didn't have parental guidance, and her parents didn't really care what we did. I partied a lot, did a lot of drugs. That was just kind of the norm at my high school. So I was an academic honor student who had gotten an acceptance letter to Ball State, but my life was just like going downhill, and I had really no other options. So my senior year, I hit rock bottom. I was dating at the time a dropout drug dealer who was also involved in gang activity, and I thought that I was completely head over heels in love with him. I thought that was the best decision of my life, so I didn't accept my offer to come to Ball State. I instead put a down payment on an apartment and decided to go to IEPY. I thought that living with him and having his child, which I was pregnant at the time, would be the best decision of my life, and that's how I would live my life. The spring semester of my senior year, my guidance counselor told me that because I didn't go to class, I wouldn't be able to graduate. So I had an academic honors diploma that I wasn't able to obtain because I stopped caring about myself, my family, my friends. I stopped caring about my grades, and I gave up my dream to come to Ball State all for this man. He taught me what it was like to have a mental, emotional, and abusive relationship. He taught me what it was like to see the gang activity, watch him sell drugs, help him sell drugs, and then I thought I was going to be a mom at the age of 17. If it wasn't for my sister Kristen, I don't know where I would be today. She consistently allowed me to sit on her couch and cry to her every single day I needed to. She was the only one that didn't judge me for who I was. She didn't judge me for any of the mistakes that I made. She was honestly my role model and my best friend, still is. I don't know where I would be without her. She's now an amazing mom, and she has the natural ability to care about people, to listen, and to deeply love them. And she's transferred all those qualities to being a really great stay-at-home mom to my 4-year-old nephew, Ethan. They are best friends. She loves him. He loves her. And it's an amazing relationship. Because of Kristen's encouragement and continual support, she aided me and encouraged me to break up with that boyfriend, accept my offer to Ball State, and talk to my guidance counselor about trying to graduate. So because of her encouragement, not force, she wasn't trying to be my mom, she was being a friend. I did all of those things. I decided to sell IEPY. No, I don't know where that down payment apartment went. I guess they still have that money. I accepted my offer to Ball State, and the summer before I came to Ball State, a couple weeks after I came to my orientation, I actually had a miscarriage. And she was there through it all. She never left my side, never has. She's my best friend. She was committed to me, she allowed me to have confidence in myself, and she also provided me with really hard conversations when I didn't want to have them. This is what OP Oprah Winfrey would describe as a mentor. Oprah describes a mentor as someone who allows you to see the light inside of yourself when it's truly too dark for you to see it. Somebody who allows you to see the higher part of yourself when sometimes it's hidden to your own view. So fast forward to freshman year at Ball State, I was still kind of lost. And long ago, I thought I wanted to be an elementary education teacher. Obviously, I'm not. But I was in EDL 100, which requires you to have 50 hours of community service. And so I walk to the service fair, and I meet Julie McGee, who is the head of this community in Ball State called Project Leadership. Project Leadership, although I didn't know what it is at the time, believes that pairing a mentor with a mentee for 4 years while they're in high school, it can provide that mentee enough love and support and encouragement for them to be able to graduate high school and for them to accept their letters to colleges. And so without even knowing what it was, I knew I needed service hours, so I signed right up. Julie saw something in me that I really didn't think I saw in myself. But a couple weeks later, I was paired with the amazing woman named Sally. From barely graduating high school, from coming to have a miscarriage, from not really understanding what I was doing at Ball State, I was now mentoring somebody else. I was now in charge of having to get her through high school when I didn't really get through high school myself. But I really utilized everything that I learned from my sister and started to put that to use with Sally. So Sally and I have been together for about 3 years now, a complete 3 years. We're moving on, we're both be seniors. She was a freshman in high school when I met her, and I was a freshman here at Ball State. We're not only a really close mentor and mentee pair, but we're very, very close friends. She calls me when I'm on duty to help her with science projects, to talk to me what it would be like to take AP classes, and to fill out her FAFSA. I was also lucky enough to meet her first ever girlfriend 3 weeks ago. You know, when I look to it, I really think that's what mentorship is. If you type mentorship into Google, you'll see that it's like in a business setting where they're mentoring somebody to be successful. But I really don't think that's what mentorship is. I look at mentorship as deeply caring about an individual, being a servant to them, and loving them and not judging them for anything that they do, and just loving them for who they are. I believe that that's what I try to do for Sally when she calls me at 12 o'clock at night and it's raining, but she needs to be picked up from work. So I had to put my pajamas on, walk across campus in the rain to get my car, go pick her up from Burger King, take her home, and then come back. But I am a servant to her, and I want her to be successful. So yes, I went and picked her up from work at 12 o'clock at night. And I might have gotten wet, and I might have been kind of pissed, but I want her to succeed. I wanted her to do her homework that night, and I wanted her to be able to wake up in the morning and go to class. And she works 30 hours a week, not even knowing if she's going to have a ride home at night, but she does it anyways. She is going to graduate a whole semester early with an associate's degree because of the program that she's in at her high school. Sally and I's story was published in a book and performed by the Ball State speech team this January at a program. But enough of my accomplishments, like how great of a mentor I am. Sally is an amazing person, and I was blessed to give her the award of Delaware County Mentee of the Year just a couple weeks ago. I was blessed to be able to sit up and talk about all of her accomplishments to a group of people that had no idea who she was, but now they do. She was so surprised. We both cried. It was a really good moment for both of us. But that's what I really think mentorship is. So my question for you all today is, do you have a mentor in your life? Do you have somebody that you talk to on a daily or a weekly basis? Somebody that will listen to your crap, your boy drama, your girlfriend drama? Somebody who loves you for the person that you are, and somebody who encouraged you to be the best you that you can be. If you don't have a mentor in your life, I would strongly encourage you to reach out to somebody, maybe a professor, maybe a family member, maybe even a friend. But not only having a mentor, being a mentor is one of the most unique and favorable experiences I've ever had at Ball State. So if you want to mentor somebody, you can talk to me about Project Leadership, or behind me on the screen are local Muncie organizations that you can start to pour into young people's lives. When I look back to it, I honestly would not be standing here presenting to you all today if it weren't for my mentor, Kristen. And I don't know where Sally would be if it weren't for myself and her life. I'm stoked to see her walk across the stage and get her diploma, and I'm excited for her to go to college. When it comes down to it, mentorship makes a difference. Thank you.